time of recession, when they're blowing $17 billion on stealth fighters, when they blow $1 billion+ mostly on pork barrel projects and the industry masters riding, but the choice to build prisons.
Yeah.
When in my riding, in Timmins, James Bay, in Englehart, in Metatchewan, and Kirkland Lake, I meet seniors all the time who can't afford to heat their houses. They have no houses to go to if they can't afford to heat them because there's no plans for senior housing. When they're being told that their guaranteed income supplement is only worth about $55 a month, that's not even a Tim Hortons medium-sized double-double. And yet this government just recently between $2 and $10 billion plan on prisons. The latest we know is it's going to be $155 million to build 576 cells. That's $270,000 per prison cell. Not counting what they're going to spend on prison guards and housing them. $270,000 on prison guards when people in my riding have no place to go when they're senior citizens. Why is this government choosing to go with the politics of fear and wasteful spending over working to help alleviate the situation for senior citizens in Northern Canada? The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Well, thank you, Mr. Speaker, and the question that the Honourable Member poses is about protecting seniors. That's exactly what we're doing. Protecting seniors against criminals. Protecting all Canadians against criminals. Every Canadian has the right to walk down a street, be it day or night, and feel safe. Mr. Speaker, if it was up to the NDP, we'd have as many criminals on the street as we do ordinary Canadians. Mr. Speaker, that is not fair. We have hardworking Canadians that expect the government to show leadership, and that's what we're showing.